O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 hours. We go. Oh my God. We go to. We go on blue crabbing, folks. That's what we're doing here. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet, folks, at TFNN. Let's go take a look at one of our four agreements. You're gonna love it, all you tigers and tigresses. Serve the one you love. Once you decide to be a couple, there to serve the one you love, to serve your love to your lover in every kiss and every touch you feel, they're there to please the one you love without expecting anything back. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 242, NASDAQ's up 108, S&P's are up 34, gold contract up $9, trading at $17.88 an ounce. Silver up 11 cents, $18.24 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 56 cents, $40.38 a barrel. Notes and bonds. We got the 10-year note right now up 5 ticks, 139.03. The 30-year up 7 ticks at 178.11. And King Dollar. King Dollar up 65 ticks, trading 97.261. The euro is at 112. The yen is at 107.5, and the British pound is at 124 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at it. What do you have? We get over and we take a look at the futures first. What you're going to see out here, futures are up by 34 points. That's a good number, folks. There's no two ways about that. They had traded as high as 31.56, down 20 points from that. But 20 points in this market is nothing, folks. And, of course, what we have had in the last 3 days is at the end of the market, bottom line did run the market going topside. Now, that being said, what I do expect we're going to see out here today, and we'll see if this is going to shake out. It looks to me like the S&P wants to come down about another 10. I don't expect this thing to go red, but I think another 10 down is going to be the way this is going to shake out. What we are going to have out here, we're going to have higher highs with a huge contraction of volume, which, by the way, it totally makes sense, you know, coming into the July 4th holiday. That being said, though, the bottom line is that when you go to higher highs, monster contraction of volume, bottom line, that is not sustainable on price. NDX 100, strength inside the NDX 100. Out here today, you get DocuSign is up 8.5%. You get Tesla up 7.5%. We get INCY up 4.5%. And you get Trip.com up 4%. Taken away from it. You have Splunk is down 1.6%. Facebook is up 1.3%. No big numbers there at all. Inside of the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials, what you have out here is that you have Microsoft putting 19 positive points, Visa putting 19, Apple putting 16, Caterpillar putting 16. Taken away from it, you only have Big Mac. Big Mac with two negative points, JP Morgan one, Cisco one. Gold contract still wants higher price, folks. What you have out here in the gold market, you're up 810. You've done 177,000 contracts. What we did out here yesterday, we did monster contract volume out here yesterday. It was 270,000, I believe. Let me see. 263. You did 263. Bottom line, what do you have here? You're pushing highs. You're pushing highs with volume. That is saying that, guess what? Higher price is going to continue out here. King Dollar, and this is where this comes down in the metals market too, folks, okay? What you have with King Dollar, King Dollar's having a hard time holding price. King Dollar should have been able to blow through the swing point that was established out here on the 22nd of June. Couldn't handle it, you know, at all, okay? Got up to the highs, gave it up. And that was only a 0.382 retracement, folks, from the leg down from May 14th. So this is going to get really intriguing in the context of how this baby is shaking out. When I was first coming on, folks, you love July 4th. You know, a couple of tigers, we're just talking about how we like July 4th. And one of the tigers, and I think that he might be from Maryland, I'm not sure, the Chesapeake, we're talking about blue crabs. And the reason I was laughing so much is that Bridget, my better half, okay, in our house sometimes when these blue crabs come in, picture, she grew up in Maryland, okay? So the bottom line is that, you know, they'd have hundreds of crabs running around, you know, the floors and, you know, basically opening them. Now, I certainly like blue crab, but I like someone picking them for me because I think you can eat like 200 blue crab and you're never going to put on a pound, you know. But bottom line is I know they're fabulous. There's no doubt about it. I grew up in Virginia. I got it. Okay, so that Chesapeake, that whole area, man, has blue crabs in a huge way. And this is the season, so I can get it. I can get it, man. I'll tell you a funny story. You know, about 5 years ago, we went to a crab restaurant down the beach in Indian Rocks Beach, and it's all you can eat, right? And so Bridget orders, we order the buckets for them, but then we say we want this big brown paper to put them on. And one of the guys came over and he knew that, okay, if you're getting a big brown paper, you're going to be here for hours. Needless to say, we were there for 4 or 5 hours. It was a blast. That's when I did pick them apart for hours. But anyway, July 4th, folks, you're going to love it. Market-wise out here. So let's take a look at this market. Let's take a look at the NDX 100 first. Actually, I want to look at DocuSign because the reason I want to look at DocuSign is this. This is really cool as my take on this is that the S&P is going to go south, and at some point, the Nasdaq's going to break down. And, you know, we had a call this morning, like, okay, when you come to tops, like, how does this normally shake out? Well, it normally shakes out, folks, that you can get, we are Krabby Bills. what you do most times is you're going to get tops that are 3 or 4 months apart. The way DocuSign is trading right now, this is what does happen. You get these expansions that are dramatic. And that's what we actually got in Tesla and Microsoft and Amazon. We got those yesterday, okay? So this is telling me that this is where we're at in the marketplace because the S&P can't hold a bid. And most times, that's how this baby shakes out. One's not holding a bid. The other one, what ends up happening, goes exponential. And then at the very end, it really goes exponential, meaning that it doesn't just go up 2 or 3 points. It goes up 15, 16, 17, and then boom, there you go. See ya. Don't want to be ya. Dow up 207, Nasdaq up 95, S&P's up 30. Stay right there, folks. We're coming back with Jason Path. We are going to be talking those jobs numbers. He's got a couple cool charts coming up that may be a little surprising. Factual data coming back.